All right, everyone, it is time. You have been asking me for a while to film a bookshelf tour, and that is what we are going to do today. I have wanted to film this video for a really long time, but as you can see, I have a lot of books, so this is going to be a long one. Let's grab a cup of tea, grab a cup of coffee, and get into it and enjoy. So we're going to try this where I'm holding the microphone and showing you the books as we go along. First thing to note is the way I organize my bookshelves is by publisher or publishing house. I think for me that just means that I can keep the collections that are meant to be together, and I love the way that it looks on my bookshelves. I have had my books organized by the surname of author. I've had them organized by color. Never really enjoyed that, but I really enjoy the setup in particular. So I think that it will probably stay like this. For those of you that don't know, we will be moving to our new house in hopefully a couple of weeks' time. So I will be setting up my bookshelves again in the new house and setting them up to be permanent, which will be very, very exciting. Top of my bookshelves over here are my Pride and Joy collection, my Penguin Drop Case Capital collection. I got this as a birthday gift a couple of years ago from my husband. It is the most beautiful collection of books I think I have ever seen and is always a talking point on my bookshelves. These books are by Penguin Publishers, and they each have a letter of the alphabet for the author's surname. And then they have these absolutely gorgeous rainbow colored covers, and they are just so beautiful to look at. I mean, they are just gorgeous. Even the pages are colored. It is just so, so beautiful, and I absolutely, absolutely love them. So that is my first sort of big collection of books that I have. We will then attempt to swivel this way. So I just have a very cute little hardback over here, which is, you see this, also a Penguin Classics hardback cover. It is of Thomas More's Utopia, and I just think it's super, super cute, and I just love it, and it kind of adds to the whole color situation. This is my jar of bookmarks. I think every reader has these. I try and use bookmarks. I don't always succeed in using bookmarks, but nevertheless, there is my jar of bookmarks. We then have these really beautiful sort of leather bound editions of books that I was gifted at various times in my life. So I have a collection of Jane Austen's books here. Problem with this collection is that it's only got four of her six novels in there. So it's beautiful and I won't ever get rid of it because it was a gift, but it just kind of bothers me that it doesn't have all the books in there. I then have a gorgeous copy of The Iliad and the Odyssey by Homer, which is so, so pretty. And then these three books were gifted to me by a family friend: John Fowles, The French Lieutenant's Woman, Henry James's The Portrait of a Lady, and Charles Dickens' Great Expectations. I used that opportunity to move into my Penguin cloth-bound classics that I have, and the ones that I have here are just Charles Dickens novels. I want to collect all of his works in the Penguin Clothbound editions eventually. At the moment, I only have David Copperfield, Oliver Twist, and A Christmas Carol. Then that leads into the Virago Modern Classics collections that I have over here. Virago, I believe, only publish female authors, so I just think they're so, so pretty. So they have them in the hardback and they have them in the softback, and unfortunately this collection split up because I picked up these two a bit later on, but I would like to keep them together. But look how gorgeous these covers are. They are just so, so pretty. I love the Virago Modern Classics. So I have Good Behavior by Molly Keane, My Cousin Rachel, Rebecca, and the Birds short stories by Daphne du Maurier, and really gorgeous. I then have this really beautiful leather-bound copy of Don Quixote by the World Cloud Classics. I haven't seen them really, but I really love this, so I picked this up. I have a Faber copy of Ishiguro's The Remains of the Day, which is really, really beautiful. And then a HarperCollins J.R.R. Tolkien's The Fellowship of the Ring. I think you can see that this top shelf is kind of like special collections and hardbacks and things like that. We continue on the collection with this very, very interesting collection of books, which is the Irish Independent collection of books. It's 20 books in total, but I managed to pick up this entire collection from my secondhand bookstore, and it's got incredible titles in here. It's got Schindler's List, The Old Man and the Sea, Breakfast at Tiffany's, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Lord of the Flies, etc., etc., Lolita, Midnight's Children by Salman Rushdie, Beloved by Toni Morrison. Such an interesting collection, so I was thrilled that I got my hands on it. I then have these Everyman's Library Pocket Poet books. I also want to collect these. I think they are so, so cute with their little spines, the different color spines. I've got Frost, Plath, and Dickinson at the moment, but you know, hoping to collect them all. My good old beautiful James Joyce's Ulysses, which I've mentioned 1,001 times, but this facsimile is of the original 1922 publicated version of Ulysses, and I have actually seen a first edition in the Museum of Literature in Dublin. It's absolutely gorgeous. In this corner here, which I'm hoping you can see, is kind of all my older cloth-bound pieces that I have, that I've collected from, you know, various stages. I have a Wuthering Heights here that I got from a antique store, which is really, really special to me. I also have a couple of these miniature collections of Shakespeare's plays, which I've started to collect. Essentially, what I want to do is be able to collect one of these little mini Shakespeare plays every time I go and see one of the Shakespeare plays. So at the moment, I only have A Midsummer Night's Dream and King Richard III, but you know, we will continue on the collection. I've got a first edition of After Strange Gods by T.S. Eliot, which is absolutely incredible. And then my pride and joy, which is this first edition of The Fountainhead by Anne Rand, and it's absolutely incredible. I have an Oxford edition of Shakespeare's Complete Works and the Oxford Book of English Verse, as well as this really beautiful Wordsworth collection of all of the Bronte sisters novels. So I'm really hoping you're going to be able to capture this in the frame, but I have this gorgeous collection, also from my secondhand bookstore, of Penguin Great Loves collection. So it's 20 books that have been pulled into this collection all about love, and I really, really adore that collection. It's so, so pretty, and yeah, just love it. You may have noticed that we are now moving on to paperback collections of books. So I then have my Penguin Modern Classics. These are in the light blue spines, and I've also got the sort of mini modern classics also in the light blue spines. I don't have all of these, I'm still collecting them as I go along, but I've also got a few of the Penguin Modern Classics in the white spines, which were the spines that were the Penguin Modern Classic spines before the blue spines came out. So they are the white spines. I've also got another one up here, which should be in there, but there is no space. And then I've got a variety of Penguin paperback collection books here. So the Times collections, I believe these are the non-fiction Penguin collections, and then the sci-fi sort of started on those. Slowly but surely, I'm hoping to get most of them. And then here I've got my Penguin English Library collections. I think most people would have seen these in the store. They are so, so pretty. I absolutely adore them. And where I don't want to collect sort of on the classic side, where I don't want to collect one of these special editions that I have, then I will collect them in the Penguin English Library, because they are by far my favorite looking book. So for example, I've got Shelley's Frankenstein, Stoker's Dracula, Robert Louis Stevenson's Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, Oscar Wilde's The Picture of Dorian Gray, Joseph Conrad's Heart of Darkness, etc., etc. And I really love them. So those will continue. I've then got these very, very cool Penguin Orange Edition books. I believe that all of these books come out of an American collection. I will double check those. But I have managed to snag, I think, almost all of these. And I just think they have got such cool covers. Just so, so interesting. So pretty. And then up here, which hopefully you can see, is a couple of the older Penguin Orange spines, which are very, very cool. Moving on, I'm still sticking with Penguin though, so this entire shelf is just Penguin publishers. I've got some of my Penguin Black Spine books. You can see these are maybe a tad bit older. Some of them I've had for a really, really long time, and some of them I've just picked up from secondhand stores. I have one Penguin Gray Spine, which is Gene Rice's Wide Sargasso Sea, which I've had. This was my first copy and I absolutely love it. And then I've got these really beautiful editions of the Orwell collection in Penguin. I think they're so cool. And then a few of these little Penguin mini classics. I've only got two. I would like to get all of them though, obviously. So just had to shift around the camera angles a bit here, but we are moving on to my vintage Red Spine collection over here. I think this is the biggest collection that I have. Also got a few sort of smaller ones here, or standing out ones. I then have these beautiful Virginia Woolf vintage collection books and the Russian vintage classics books. Apart from War and Peace, I still haven't gotten War and Peace, and it is one of the ones that I've actually read. I then have the beautiful Fitzcarraldo editions in the blue and white spines. I would like to have all of them together, obviously, but I pick them up in different stages. I then have two of these Lives of Caesar and the History collection, and Homer's The Odyssey and Ovid's Metamorphosis, which I just threw in here. I think they look very, very cool. And then I have these Bloomsbury Library collections. I think these covers look so cool, as well as a Persephone book. We then move on to my third shelf, which has all of my hardback books in here. And I'm not a massive hardback book fan, but a lot of these I picked up secondhand, and I just like that they're all kind of together. The publishing house sort of section of this kind of goes out of the door, but I still try and piece them together, which is why I have these Penguin children's classics lined up, my Oxford University collection lined up, the Tilted Access collections of translated works, and the Wordsworth collections over here in the black spines. I think they look really, really cool. I then have three Everyman Library books and the Riggs Hollow City collections. Then we move on to my pride and joy in the bottom shelf, which is my Harry Potter collection. Most of these are first editions, apart from the Chamber of Secrets, which you can see the spine is slightly newer because I couldn't find my original Chamber of Secrets, but the rest of these I've had for years, and they are, the dust covers are looking a bit sun damaged. I then have my Arden Shakespeare collections for all the plays that I've looked at. I have my poetry sort of pile and short story pile in here, which I really, really love, and I would like to have more prominent place on my new shelves. And then we get into the massive pile of contemporary fiction books that I have just not organized in the slightest on the bottom shelf of my shelves. I am really hoping that in the new house, when I put up my shelves, I will have more shelf space and I will be able to display all of these books and not have them doubled up like this and have them properly organized in the new shelves in the new house, which I will record and share with you all. I then have this little basket which has some of my university textbooks in it. So this dictionary of symbols, the European history or Europa history by Norman Davies, and my massive poetry encyclopedia and literary criticism book. I then also have this trolley which has my current TBR reads that I still need to read, as well as the four, I think I only have three, I'm trying to get the last one, but the Irish Booker long list books and some of the books that I have pulled out for my upcoming masters that I will be starting in October. If I flip this trolley around, you can see there is more books here in the back that just don't fit standing upright. So some for the MLA, one for my 2023 TBR, and two of the Booker long list books that are by Irish authors. I'm so looking forward to the move and to be able to display my books in some bigger bookshelves. So I will be exploring new setups, new bookcases that I can put my books in, and I'm really looking forward to that. I'll also be packing up my books pretty soon, so this is probably the last video that you'll see with them in the background, which is kind of a bittersweet moment. I think it's going to look really, really beautiful in the new house, but this has obviously been the foundation and the backdrop of my channel for the beginning part of it, and so it still has a very special place in my heart. But I do hope you enjoyed this video and you will stick around for the next installment when I will be moving and setting up my bookshelves in the new house.